Ladies, gentlemen, boys, and girls, hockey fans of all ages, hello and welcome into the Rockland Ice Arena for tonight's Varsity ice hockey matchup. It is the Blue Hills Regional Warriors and the Abington Green Wave. As always, I'm Mad Dog Matt Nelson, bringing you all the action high above the ice. We are live on YouTube. We hope to remain that way. But as we did last game, we are having a little bit of internet trouble so far to start this game. The Warriors wearing their visiting blue jerseys, black shorts with black trim around the white numbers lettering. The Green Wave in their home white jerseys, black shorts and black trim around the green numbers and lettering. Blue Hills with the opening offensive zone possession here. Full disclosure, we do not have a roster for the Warriors. Number 9 on his backhand goes D to D over to number 21. We're going to work on getting a roster at some point during this game. We do have one for the Green Wave. We'll run down their lines. Cullen Crocker was promoted to the top line center. His wings are Sam McDonald and Kevin Cashman. Jake Quinn is centering the second line. Evan St. Martin and Hunter Grafton are the wings on that line. Callie Pino is the third line center. Her wingers are Jack Shea and Declan McCarthy. Cam Pino is centering the fourth line for Abington. John McGrath and Mikey Johnson are his wingers. The defensive pairings, Ryan Tobin once again with Aiden Powers. Zach Buchagross is with Eric Wilkinson, and Travis Swanson is with Colin McDermott.
Go with them.
The goaltender is none other than number 30, Spencer Merrick, who makes a great save on the 2-on-1 and didn't get a piece of the rebound that was left in front. Did number 24. Abington back the other way. Their shot swallowed up by the Warriors goaltender. He holds on for the faceoff with a delayed whistle there. By Aiden Powers at the point, it ricochets into the Warrior goalkeeper's glove. He holds once again. Both teams coming into this one at 1-1, one win, one loss. The Green Wave coming off an 8-0 throttling at the Bug in Kingston against their divisional rival, the Norwell Clippers. Another opportunity out in front goes sliding down. Was Buchagross. No shot was lodged during that. Now number 9 retrieves for the Warriors. Spinning, trying to get away from Aiden Powers, the defenseman playing all the way forward. Another stop, the blue line for Powers. Now Callie Pino finds the loose change. Her shot is blocked aside. Declan McCarthy scrapping for the loose puck. Callie Pino spins and shoots. It didn't get through, and another turnover by Blue Hills, and great work by the Green Wave to keep it in the offensive zone. Tobin can't get that one, but he's going to be called for interference as he held up the Blue Hills Warrior just enough at the blue line. First power play opportunity of the game. It will be for the Warriors. It comes with 11:57 to go in the first period. Number 7 in to take the face off. This one rides the rail on the blue line. Now Powers. Ref washes out the plate with a high stick sign, and the Warriors attempt to set it up with 20 seconds of the power play gone. They'll have to tag up and clear out, as couldn't keep it in at the blue line was number 8. And number six dumps it far corner, but it's intercepted by the Green Wave and dumped all the way down the river. 1:25 to go in the power play, 11:15 in the period. Number 21 gains the blue line, his shot rides the ice and goes wide. Colin Crocker dumps it all the way down. The first 60 of the power play are gone.
Skate it up, Joe. Skate it up. Go with him. Go with him.
Buchagras threw the body to create separation. The Warriors keep it in the zone. Now at the top of the key, number 8 down low to number 9. He takes a massive hit. And that separates the puck. The Green Wave player responsible for that. And now a shorthanded opportunity. It is Evan St. Martin. Shoots and scores! Evan St. Martin shorthanded. And the Green Wave are on top with 10:21 to go in the first. That is Evan St. Martin's first goal of the season. I don't think there'll be an assist given on that one. Back to the power play. Another big hit, that one laid down by Powers. Rather, that was Evan St. Martin, who's feeling some type of energy after scoring a goal and dishing out a massive hit, and another. Jake Quinn spins and clears it all the way down. Icing waved off of the power play. They say we'll have 1 second remaining when the puck was cleared. Tobin out of the box, back to even strength. Stopped by number 16, Kevin Cashman. Now Powers up to Sam McDonald. Shot, and the Warriors goalkeeper has this one. He holds the faceoff with 9:28 to go in the first. It's 1-0 Abington on top. Blue Hill's able to win the faceoff, but pinching the point is Ryan Tobin, kept it in at least momentarily. Now, Powers lost an edge, and the Green Wave recovered defensively. It is Sam McDonald.
Don't let him out. Ah, geez.
Now Crocker sweeps it through the neutral zone. That lets the Green Wave kind of reset a little bit. Looking out in front for McDonald. Crocker around the boards. He was looking for Wilkinson. And the Warriors back up ice. McDonald took a big hit to move the puck. Wilkinson up to the red line, and now a 2-on-1 developing for the Green Wave. It is Quinn who passed over to Hunter Grafton. It didn't go. Yeah. 8:15 to go in the first.
Get in.
The lone goal was a shorthanded goal.
Stay in.
By that guy, Evan St. Martin, who's got the puck now. Up to Quinn. Quinn's saucer is handled by Hunter Grafton. Long stretch of continuous play here. Calipino disrupts in the neutral zone. Now Declan McCarthy lost his twig. He'll come to the bench for a change, rather Grafton does. Blue Hill's another wild clearing attempt, and just missing it at the blue line was Powers. Green Wave tag up and pressure the puck immediately once again. This one sent all the way down, icing against the Warriors. It comes with 7:16 to go in the first period. This game taking place on Wednesday, December 22nd, as you may have figured by the background music playing here at the rink.
You're good for now, you're good for now.
All those celebrating, Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, Happy New Year, Happy Festivus, Happy Kwanzaa, and anything I may have missed. Cali Pino throws the body, and the Green Wave gained possession from that.
Hey!
Another great play. This was number 22, Jack Shea, catching it on the back end. The name of the Green Wave's game plan has been clogging passing lanes, intercepting passes, especially in the neutral zone, and really trying to control possession in all three zones of the ice. Crocker gains entry. His shot, he scores! Crocker on a little check knee shot from the blue line, a soft wrister, and it caught the Warriors goalkeeper off guard. They found the back of the net. It's 2-0 Abington. That is Cullen Crocker's first goal of the season.
Keep it in the blue. On the blue line defense, keep it in. Be on your man.
Off the ensuing faceoff, it is the Green Wave with possession. All the way in on the Warriors goalkeeper. He elects to play it over to number 9. Crocker lays the hit. The Green Wave once again pinch off the seam and keep the puck in the offensive zone. Now sent through for Aiden Powers back in the defensive side of the ice. Poke check, and it's a 4-on-2 for the Green Wave. Crocker leading the way. He lost possession of the puck. A backhand shot from the back door. Was that Quinn or McDonald? It was McDonald. And the Warriors freeze the puck. Very dedicated student section here at Rockland Ice Rink for the Abington Green Wave. Decked out in all of their finest Christmas attire. Green Wave in the faceoff, sticked aside by the Warriors goalkeeper. And a 2-on-1 now for the Warriors. A shot patted away by Spencer Merritt.
Get up there.
Merritt's been pretty decent so far. A 9.18 save percentage. That's great numbers, especially for a junior. In two games played, one of which included an 8-0 shellacking against one of the toughest in the league. Big hit, and it will result in a penalty for interference. To the box goes, let's see, is it Tobin again? It is Ryan Tobin, the captain, headed to the box once again. The 100 or so referees behind the glass don't agree with the call.
Turn around, go ahead, Jake.
the second Blue Hills power play. They are 0-for-1, and they have given up a shorthanded goal. Also with Tobin in the box. First 30 of the power play are already gone. Hit backhanded, but Powers out to the blue line. The Warriors keep it in. A one-time deflects. The rebound attempt. And the Green Wave cleared out from in front. Blue Hills missed the open net there. Now another opportunity for the Warriors. Minute to go on the power play. 3:45 in the period. This one sent out in front. Another big hit laid down by the Green Wave. This one goes just over the crossbar. And the Blue Hills team with the most extended period of play they've had in the offensive zone by far this game. They threw in a shot looking for a screen in front. Merrick saw it all the way and got it in his catcher's mitt. Merrick, a big part of this Green Wave team. He was all of last year as he was with the Green Wave baseball team. Also the backstop there.
In, Zach.
Green Wave cleared all the way down. 35 seconds to go in the power play for Blue Hills.
Come
on. It is St. Martin fighting for the puck. To even strength. The Green Wave possessed the puck. Tobin tried to go in defensively all the way down, icing against the Warriors is the call. And they'll come all the way back down. To clear it out into the neutral zone before Tobin gets a piece of it. Another icing against the Warriors. 1:56 to go. Big hit laid down. Tobin with the contact there. Calipino with it.
Get in, Bobby.
90 seconds to go in the first. With it behind the net.
Stay in! There you go, stay in, Bobby!
Green Wave carry out now with under a minute to go. Cashman. Blue Hills dumps it deck deeper with 30 seconds to go now in the period.
Keep it in, Rice.
And Merrick Smith once again. He holds for the faceoff with 20.2 to go. Opportunity, Sam McDonald in with a little bit of a lane. He gets held up. The arms stay down.
No.
1 second to go. The buzzer sounds. The first period has come to an end. It is 2-0 Abington, including a shorthanded goal, Evan St. Martin. And Cullen Crocker, the two tallies for the Green Wave. That's where we stand at the end of one. We're going to step aside, take a quick break, and bring you second period action right after this. Hello, and welcome back into the Rockland Ice Rink for second period action between the Blue Hills Regional Warriors and your Abington Green Wave. Once again, I'm Mad Dog Matt Nelson, bringing you all of the action high above the ice. Here in Rockland, the score is 2-0. Abington is leading. There was a shorthanded goal scored by Cohen Crocker. Evan St. Martin as well.
Come up.
Opportunity for the Warriors. It is shut down by the staunch Green Wave defense. And McDonald dumped it in chase. The Green Wave change out their forward line. Turned over, Hunter Grafton takes it. Now popped all the way up. It's going to be an opportunity for Quinn, who can't swat at it. Out in front, it's loose in the crease, and it sat there in the blue paint for a couple of seconds. Now the Green Wave buzzing around the net once again. It's Evan St. Martin's on the sweep around the boards. Now Hunter Grafton out to the blue line for Zach Buchagross. His shot deflects off of a Warriors stick and into the protective netting. The clock stops with 13:31 to go in the period. Offsides against the Green Wave. Shot zings wide, it came from St. Martin. Green Wave back out into the neutral zone. Up for Jake Quinn. He chases into the corner, feathers it through to Grafton. And Quinn retrieves once again in the corner. And the Warriors able to clear out. Icing waved off for the Green Wave. Quinn in once again, he gets held up. The Warriors take possession. And we'll have another penalty. This will be, they delayed offsides. They wave it off as the Green Wave tagged up. I thought Quinn might have gotten tagged for a trip.
Stay in luck, Jake.
opportunity. It is Jack Shea who couldn't corral the puck for a shot. Butchagos off the boards for Declan McCarthy. Kelly Pino scrapping for the puck. She was featured in the Enterprise actually this morning.
Get open, Wayne, get open.
Whiffing on the shot was number 9 for the Warriors. It leads to a 4-on-1. Here is Ryan Tobin. He shoots and scores 5-4. Ryan Tobin goes in and shuts out the Green Wave student section. And it is 3-0 Green Wave with 11:20 to go in the second period. Tobin from Pino and McCarthy, it looks like. Of course, Ryan Tobin had to skate over and pay homage to the fan section that in every other sport he leads every single game. And was rightly recognized by those group of Green Wave students. 3-0 Green Wave, 11 minutes to go in the second, and in the clear out is Wilkinson. Holding now is Cashman. Wraps it around. Lost the handles in the far side corner. Green Wave get it back, and it was McDonald trying from behind the net. Wilkinson retrieves and still has possession. He launches a cross that goes all the way through. Tobin makes a nice move. Tobin, D to D over to Cashman. Now Wilkinson whiffs on it. It might have been for the better. Feathered out in front, a shot, and it is just a massive pile of carnage out in front of the net. Skips the heel of Tobin's stick, and the Green Wave have to tag up. Tobin makes a nice move. Now the defenseman leading the rush. Over to the collision with McDonald, and Cashman couldn't get a shot off. Now Cashman goes down. There'll be a penalty. Merrick to the bench for the extra attacker. Powers down low. Quinn circling the wagons out in front. A shot in, another rebound! It is Ryan Tobin with his second in just about as many minutes. It is 4-0 Green Wave. They don't need the power play to accomplish it.
Come low!
Tobin from McDonald and McCarthy. Not much you could do there if you're a Green Hills goaltender. Green Wave swarming out in front. He made the initial save.
Stay aggressive, Blue Hills.
And Tobin
aggressive.
Found it on ice, back door with nobody else around. One rings all the way around. The Warriors keep it in the offensive zone. And the Blue goaltender freezes the puck and holds for the faceoff with 9:11 to go in the second. Caught by Aiden Powers at the blue line. Now Butchagross, nice move. deflection out in front for Quinn. He's got it on the wraparound attempt, and Blue Hill's able to clear it, but not out, at least initially. Now it goes all the way down the river. It will be an icing. Oh no, they wave it off. Clock stops with 8.5 minutes to go. Merrick was down now. The green wave clear to the half wall to give him the opportunity to get back up. This one pops into the protective netting and out the other side. Brief in, tried to throw it back. McCarthy gets it down low. Blue line for Butchergrass. Back to McCarthy. McCarthy took a wicked hit. Shakes out the cobwebs. The puck bounced back to Pino. There'll be a penalty. Merrick to the bench once again for the extra attacker, but the Warriors able to touch this one up. And the call. Going to be boarding, I believe. Tobin off the faceoff. Shot blocked aside by the shin of number 9. D to D back to Tobin now. 5-on-4 for the next minute and 45 or less. Butchergrass out in front. Other side, it's Butchergrass who couldn't field it cleanly. And the Warriors slap it all the way down the river. Just 30 seconds of the power play gone.
Meet him there. Joe, meet him. Meet him, Joe.
Tobin flies up once again, dumps it, but the Warriors able to field that and send it all the way back down, played by Spencer Merrick behind his net. Butchergrass, of course, the nephew of ESPN anchor and commentator John Butchergrass. Grafton, Tobin's one-timer, oh, and it got a piece of the wrong team. It hit the wrists of number 9 for the Green Wave, Evan St. Martin.
Stay with it!
That's it, Bobby. Hey, Hunter. And Tobin's blast caught the left wrist of St. Martin on his way through the crease. He remains on the Green Wave bench. Looking for the McCarthy deflection out in front. It pops out into the neutral zone now with 10 to go on the power play. 5:45 left in the period. A shot off the helmet. That's what I call using your head, off the helmet of the Warriors goaltender. And they send it all the way down. And we're back to even strength. Yeah. Another opportunity forming for the Green Wave. Crocker has it pickpocketed by number 9. And he missed on the hit, and Aiden Powers got hit instead of dishing one out. Crocker a little bit shaken up. He skates over to the Green Wave bench. Puck battle, Powers and Cashman in on this one.
Where's the wing? Get into position.
4:18 to go in the second. It's 4-0. The Green Wave lead.
Look.
Cashman overskated, ends up coming up with a poke check now, 2-on-1. If McDonald's can get away from his defender, he cannot. Power sweeps it up and a wicked hit, but clean on core number 2. Aiden Powers, for those who might not know, is one of the offensive and defensive linemen on the football team. He carries some serious size and power with him. He goes in again and he'll get called for a hit up high. Here on number 2, he's going for a hit again and just got his gloves up around the neck. Blue Hills 0-for-2 on the power play so far. I do not believe they have registered a shot on the power play. They did have that great sequence. On their last power play, they have also given up. The first Abington goal of the night was a shorty. Number 9 retrieves far side half wall. Butchergrass collects, spanks it around the boards. Blue Hills able to keep it in, however, now with a minute and a half left on the power play. This one goes wide. Merrick was caught spinning. This one blocked down in front and collected by number 7 of the Warriors. Stick save by Merrick. Butchergrass finds the loose puck and backhands it all the way out. Contact on Quinn, who was dragged down, no call. Rather, that was St. Martin again. Butchergrass plays it out from the low slot. And this goes all the way down, 50 seconds to go. And a backhanded shot to the goal! McDonald is the first one to the puck, and he swept the backhand right over the Warriors' goaltender and in. The second shorthanded goal of the night for the Green Wave. That is McDonald's first goal of the season, the 8th grader. Not only the first goal of the season, the first goal of his Green Wave career. They saved the puck. 5-0 Green Wave, 45 seconds to go on the power play.
Dayton, look!
Turned over to Sam McDonald. All the way through, McDonald goes buzzing in. He's got his first taste, he wants more. softly off of the end wall now with 15 to go on the power play.
Oh, elbow. Jeez.
Cashman pinching the wall. McDonald makes a nice move, has it on his backhand. Tries to feather it through back to Cashman. Back to even strength. That was all shorthanded, folks. Cashman got taken down. And Blue Hills able to possess. They have not yet cleared their defensive zone.
Get out, 2-2. Skate.
Now they do. 1:05 to go in the second. Merrick seals this one off with his glove and holds for the faceoff with 59 seconds to go. Bodies fly a little bit in later stages. Now 40 seconds to go in the second frame. Green wave up big. It's 5-0. Abington leading Blue Hills Regional. Hoping to just escape without giving up any further damage. He'll carry up now with 10. The shot ramps up into the netting and we'll have a face-off with 3.9 to go. Kelly Pino wins the faceoff. Wilkinson clears it over to McCarthy. As the buzzer sounds and the second frame has come to an end, the Green Wave add three more, including Sam McDonald's first career. It is 5-0. The Green Wave lead it at the end of two. We're going to step aside, take a quick break, and bring you third period action right after this.
Come on, guys.
Hello, and welcome back into the Rockwood Ice Rink. Third period action between the Blue Hills Regional Warriors and the Abington Green Wave. Once again, I'm Matt Dog, Matt Nelson, bringing you all of the action high above the ice here in Rockland. The score, a decisive one. It is 5-0 Abington. Two short-handed goals included in that tally. Let's see, Crocker's got one. McDonald's got his first career goal. St. Martin scored one. Tobin's got two. Merrick seals off and finds the puck underneath him and holds for the stop. Both teams coming in at 1-1 overall. Blue Hills off the faceoff, number 13. Backhands to Merrick's right pad. Thank you. Cashman keeps it through now. McCarthy. Cashman, the veteran on the ice, along with Quinn and Cali Pino and Declan McCarthy. A little bit of a shift as McDonald's out there too. That's McDonald, Cashman, and Declan McCarthy. The two defensemen were Buchagross and Powers. All the way down, icing called against the Green Wave. Player for the Green Wave wearing number 19. He is not listed on our roster. We'll try to figure out who he is. Looks like it could be Colin McDermott. Tobin off the faceoff. Tobin finds a lane now to the far side corner. Quinn finds it behind the net, makes a nice move. Tobin far side half wall out to the blue line for Hunter Grafton. This one swept aside into stoppage. The net has come off the moorings. The game, 12:03 to go in the third. I stepped aside to figure out who number 19 is. I believe it is Mikey Johnson, who is listed as number 26. Further research needed to confirm. 5-1 the score with sub 12 minutes to go in the third period. He was number 9 for the Warriors. Big hit laid down by Powers, and it's going to be a penalty. Powers just saw the arm in the air and says, what is the call? Because that was looked like a clean hit. Green Wave touch it up. And the penalty. Interference is the call on Powers. He's in the box for the second time tonight. Thank you. Thank you for joining us on the Abington Cam YouTube live stream, if we're up. YouTube.com/AbingtonCam02351/live. If you miss a game, want to watch a game back, want to catch a government meeting, or otherwise, a shot. Glove save, Merrick rebound attempts. Pops out. And a penalty upcoming on Blue Hills. Or no, they're going to call it on Abington? It is Sam McDonald in the box. He went down. So that's an interesting call, as I was saying. AbingtonCam.tv, live streams on cable access channels, on-demand video, bulletin board information, and more. Calling for the one-timer with some space now. 5-on-3 for the next 90, minute and six. Merrick makes the save and falls on top of it for the stop. 5-1 the score, an extended power play opportunity for the Warriors. They're 0-for-3 so far. Shot blocked away by Buchagross. Snapped twig on the one-timer attempt from the faceoff dot. 40 seconds to go on the 5-on-3. Blue Hills swarming. Couple of tired members of the Green Wave out there. Over the clear, but not out. Number 8 punches it down at the blue line. 23 seconds left in the 5-on-3. This one will go all the way out into the neutral zone, and Blue Hills forced to chase. Tobin and Buchagross stay out there, along with Evan St. Martin. Shot goes wide, 5-on-4 now for 38 seconds. 0-for-4 on the power play so far are the Warriors. Out in front, blocked aside by Tobin, and sent all the way down with 25 seconds to go on the power play. Ten to go, last rush for Blue Hills on the extended 5-on-3. They will get nothing from it. McDonald out of the box, even strength, 8.5 to go. Big penalty kill for the Green Wave.
Nice play.
Quinn tries a self-pass, Cashman retrieves it. Tobin, a nice move. Now Cashman comes back and gains possession again. Sam McDonald carries in his soft shot. That's what led to the first goal. Blue Hills goaltender dives on top of it. He holds for the stop. 7:27 to go in the third period. It is 5-1 Abington. tie up on the half wall will lead to a face off. Cali Pino does some work to keep the puck in. Kept in by the Warriors, shot blockered away by Merrick. Powers to Wilkinson. Now up for Jack Shea. Shot, glove save by the Blue Hills goalkeeper, and he holds. Kept in at the blue line by Tobin. Download of Grafton, who makes a nice move. Hunter Grafton working his way towards net. His shot popped just wide. Now tripped up is Evan St. Martin. The arms stay down. Powers up for Quinn, who lost an edge. Green wave with another successful poke check. Hunter Grafton turning on the Jets. Hunter Grafton tries to make a nice move, and the Blue Hills Warriors able to separate him from the puck. Now St. Martin's shot blocked aside by a Warriors stick in front. One timer looking deflection, rebound attempts for Quinn goes wide. Quinn stops it on the half wall. Out to the blue line for Tobin. Tobin backhands over to Mikey Johnson. Sent all the way down for icing with 5:14 to go in the third period. Win the faceoff. Buchagross's shot blocked away, and Blue Hills trying to turn some transition out of it. Number 27 shot blocked away by Skate. McCarthy looking up for McDonald's, a little bit too far. Powers collects and skies it back towards Merrick, who gloves it down. Buchagross backhands it around looking for Powers, now McDonald. Shot stick save Merrick. Five to go, third period, 5-1 Abington. The differential at 4. Cali Pino. Now Aiden Powers. Powers gets hit down. Pino recovers. Pino loses the puck. Now gets it back. Dumps and chases. Retrieves with 3.5 to go in the third. Pretty good stretch of continuous play here. Tobin goes all the way down once again. Yeah. Donald finds an opening on the wing. His shot blocked away. Two and a half consecutive minutes here of play. A shot, another save. The rebound attempt is under there somewhere. The Green Wave kept pounding away. And the continuous play comes to a stop with 2:43 to go in the third. I want to take this opportunity to thank our cameraman for bringing you the sights and sounds from Rockland Ice Rink tonight. The one, the only, Hayden Prescott. Did a great job in his first Green Wave hockey action. Quick icing called against the Warriors with 2:33 to go. Been a eclectic mix of music tonight between Christmas songs. Now we've got the escape song, a one-timer coming for Grafton. Oh, what a save! Flush the letter, why don't you? Number 31 for Blue Hills with a phenomenal stop there. See if he can do it again. This one might have got a piece of the glove. It goes to the end wall. Tobin keeps it in. Tobin's pass finds St. Martin. Now out to Wilkinson. Wilkinson dumps it back down. The pass too close to the middle of the ice. It goes all the way down. Sub 2 minutes to go. 1:50 in the third period. Tobin lost it. The shot blocked down by Merrick. Wilkinson cleans up the loose garbage. And it's sent all the way down, deflected off of Blue Hills. So no icing now with 90 seconds to go. The Green Wave possess forward of the goal line. Blue Hills ices the puck. And it'll come all the way back down with 1:17 to go. Tie up on the faceoff. The Green Wave eventually win it. Mikey Johnson can't hold it on the blue line. Johnson eventually gets possession back, slaps it through the neutral zone. Now 60 seconds to go. Johnson at the point, launches one. A headhunter goes cross slot. McDonald, who scored his first career Green Wave goal earlier tonight. Tobin collects, or rather Buchagross, backhands it over to Johnson, 30 seconds to go. Johnson takes a big hit. Out in front, Merrick gets his glove on the attempt. A little bit of holiday pleasantries exchanged with 16.2 seconds to go. Abington will improve to 2-1. Blue Hills will fall to 1-2. This one goes wide, far right. Jack Shea just going to hold it on the boards for as much of the next 6 seconds as he can. It's scored loose. out in front. Blue Hills looking for a last second whack at it. Kelly Pino collects. The buzzer sounds and this one has come to an end. The Green Wave victorious for the second time here at the Rockland Ice Rink. They're undefeated here at home. They improved to 2-1 on the year. Blue Hills again falls to 1-2. Let's see the five goals. Colin Crocker scored one. Sam McDonald scored his first career goal for the Green Wave. Connor Grafton had one. And Ryan Toby had two for the Green Wave. Meanwhile, number 9 was the only goal scorer for the Warriors. I want to thank you for watching this production of Abington Community Access and Media. Another one, and we'll take a Christmas break now and be back at you next Monday afternoon. I believe it's 11:30 a.m. puck drop here in Rockland as the Green Wave take on the Bulldogs of Rockland. Until then, we again thank our cameraman Hayden Prescott for bringing you the sights and sounds from Rockland tonight. And on behalf of everyone here at Abington Community Access and Media, I'm Mad Dog Matt Nelson, and we will see you next game.